Hi, my name is Thomas Kim. In this session, we will learn absolute fundamentals of C++ on Windows using either Visual Studio 2015 or Visual Studio 2017. So, prerequisites of this video is you have to install Visual Studio Code. You can download Visual Studio Code from this website, or you can download Visual Studio from this website, Visual Studio 2017. I will put the link of these URLs in the description section. In this video, you can download the Community Edition, and also you can download Visual Studio Code. Okay, I hope you install both Visual Studio 2017 and Visual Studio Code. Please install both if you haven't installed them. Or if you want to install Visual Studio 2015, please click this link. From this link, you can download all the version of Visual Studio like this. You can download Visual Studio 2015 by clicking this link. Whatever you do, I assume you installed Visual Studio Code because we will be using Visual Studio Code in this session. Also, either you install Visual Studio 2017 or install Visual Studio 2015. We will learn fundamentals about C++ programming. Especially, we will learn what does command line switch means, or what compilation means, what link means, or we will also learn what pre-processing means, and we will also learn the term translation unit, and two different ways to define pre-processing macros. We will learn a lot of things in this video. These are absolute fundamentals when you develop software using C++ language. Okay, let's get started. If you cannot find Visual Studio shortcuts or icons on your desktop, then click this link, right click, then search. You can type in Visual Studio. Then if you install the Visual Studio 15, then you will find this icon. Right click, pin to taskbar. Then you will find Visual Studio taskbar icon is created here. Also, if you install the Visual Studio 7, pin to taskbar, then it will be created like this. This is Visual Studio 2017. This is Visual Studio 2015. Okay, then right click, open file location, then you will be opened like this. Then here, make it to list view like this, then scroll down or scroll up to find, here, Microsoft Visual Studio 15 folder, double click it, then Visual Studio tool, double click it, once again, Windows desktop command prompt here. Please drag 16-bit. If you are using 16-bit Windows, then click drag this tool on your desktop, copy here. Okay, you can just copy here. Then command prompt like this will be created on your desktop. Also, if you are using Visual Studio 17, Visual Studio 2017, then you can do the same thing. Visual Studio 2017, tools, then VC here. I am using 64-bit, drag and copy here. Copy here. Then you will create, if you are using Visual Studio 2015, this icon, this shortcut will be created on your desktop. If you are using Visual Studio 2017, this icon will be created. Let's test with the version first. So this is Visual Studio 2015 is called, its version is Visual Studio 14, okay? So when people say Visual Studio 2015, it means Visual Studio 14 as well. On the here, CL, This command gives CL, compiler and linker switch, Microsoft C++ optimized compiler version. This is version 19. Okay, so Now let's try with Visual Studio 2017 here. If we see it, this is Visual Studio version 14. Visual Studio 14. If you give CL command, this is called switch. Then is Visual Studio 19 CL command. C++ optimizing compiler version 19.15, something like that. So when people say I'm using Visual Studio 2017, it means the version of CL, command line linker, compiler and linker version is 19.15 or 19 point something, okay? Also, it is called Visual Studio version 15. So you have to understand the version. Visual Studio 15 is also called Visual Studio version 14. And Visual C++ 14, it is also called Visual C++ version 14. CL compiler and linker version is 19 point something. In case of you are using Visual Studio 2017, it is also called Visual Studio version 15.xx or something, or Visual C++ 15. Also, its CL compiler version is 19 point something. Please understand the version. See, Visual Studio 2015 means Visual Studio C++ version 14. Okay? When they are saying Visual Studio 2017, they are saying their CL compiler is 19 point blah blah something. So I hope you understand this concept. Also, if you cannot find Visual Code, also type Visual Studio Code, then you will see this icon. Right click, pin to taskbar, then it will be created. The icon is very similar, but a little bit different. So not, I will put it here. This is Visual Studio Code icon. This is Visual Studio 2017. So let's close this. Now we will create a folder for our work. In my case, D drive, DEV soft tutorial. I will create here a new folder by clicking this icon, this button. Say CPP tutorial. Okay, I will create a folder and double click it. Then copy this link. Then right click your command prompt properties here, starting for here, control A, control V. So we are changing the start folder like this. Click OK. Also in your Visual Studio 2017 command prompt property, starting control A, control V. Okay, now click OK. Now if you click double click it, your start folder will be changed to DEV soft tutorial, CPP tutorial, this folder. Okay, so this folder becomes our working folder. Okay, so I will now start with Visual Source Code. Before I start Visual Source Code, I will start Visual Studio 15. This is Visual Studio 2015. By default, Visual Studio's default working folder is set to something else. So we will change our working folder, Tools, Options, then scroll down. Project here, general. So by default, Visual Studio C++ generates project in this folder. No, not this folder. By default, it is set to something else, like document, Visual Studio 14, project. This is usually default folder, default project folder. So I will change it to new folder. So here I copy this folder, then copy, paste, then it becomes our new project location, new default project location. Click OK. Okay. Now I start with Visual Studio 2017. So I started the Visual Studio. Now this is Visual Studio 17. In the same way, Tools, Options, then scroll down, Project here, Location. I can do the same thing like Control V. I copied this folder. Now set like this. And because we are working both, this is Visual Studio 14, this is Visual Studio 2017, it's a little bit confusing. So I will change its color options once again. I will change the theme environment general. Here, color theme, this is Visual Studio 2017, I will say blue. Okay, now click OK. Okay, now the theme of Visual Studio 2017 is changed. Say, when you see this color, dark color, this is Visual Studio 15. And when you see blue color like this, you are seeing Visual Studio 2017. There is a slight difference between Visual Studio 2017 and Visual Studio 15. So don't get confused, okay? So let's start with Visual Studio 17. In this case, I will create, since we changed our default working folder, we just changed our default working folder, our solution will be created here. So I will create our first solution project. If you don't see Solution Explorer, then go to View, then click Solution Explorer. Then you can see Solution Explorer will be opened. For example, if I click it, Solution Explorer is gone. Go to View, then Solution Explorer will be displayed. You can drag and drop like this. You can drag it here. Now we create one new first Visual Studio project here. Since we are working on Visual C plus desktop, here console application, then this is the solution name. I say hello Visual Studio 2017 solution. This is solution name. Solution can contain project. You say CPP hello, I would say Visual Studio 2017 CPP hello. Okay, please select installed Visual Studio desktop, then Visual Studio console, then click OK. So this is our Hello World application in Visual Studio 2017. Now I will do the same thing in Visual Studio 2015. Okay, here go to File, New Project. Here C++ Windows. Here you can say Win32 in Visual Studio 2015. Visual C plus Win32 console application. Here VS 2015. Hello solution. I will name like this. Then here VS 2015 hello app. I will name like this. Click OK. Next, just finish. So if you compare Visual Studio 2015 and Visual Studio 2017, there is slight difference, right? There is a slight difference. In this case, it starts with STDAFX. In this case, it starts with include PCH, and it includes IOStream here. Then where is IOStream? If you click this, it does not include IOStream. So the starter file, these are called the starter files, are a little bit different. But if you understand the fundamentals, these difference doesn't matter. These difference do not matter at all if you understand the fundamentals. So I will work with Visual Studio 2015. I need to include, in this case, it does not include IOStream. I include IOStream. Then here, SDD, CL, Hello, C++, SDD, and there. So I close it. Then we can run this application by pressing Ctrl F5. Or you can run debug. Start without debugging. This is Ctrl F5. If you click this button, then it will compile. It will compile and link. Then it will run. Okay, it runs like this. In the same manner, since it already has stuck code hello world, we just go debug, Ctrl F5, then it is running in Visual Studio 2017. So it runs like this. So if you run, you probably learned Visual Studio this way, but it doesn't give you much information about what compile means, what link means, things like that. So let's go back in our folder, this folder. This is for Visual Studio 2017, creates folder like this. And this is Visual Studio 15, it also generates files like this, okay? Instead of doing this, we will walk in command line, okay? So we will walk in command line. Start with Visual Studio, this is Visual Studio Code. We will start Visual Studio Code like this. At this point, click this button here, open folder, then select C++ tutorial folder here, click this link, select folder, then it will open like this. Okay, now instead we will create the hello world using command line. Okay, command line. So we will create here a folder, click this one, you see cpp hello world. We are making a folder here. Select this folder again, then select hello cpp like this. Okay, then we create folder here. Now we create a function int main. We need to include, to print our message, we need to include iostream. Okay, so this is called preprocessor directive include. Okay, so at this point we can use this header file. Iostream header file defines object like STD. See out. We are doing the same thing. Hello world, C++ command line. Okay, then SDD and okay, we created a message like this. Then we return Jira. To save this file, Control S saves the file. Then in command prompt here, if it is not open, you can open like this. Here, you can open Visual Studio, you are using Visual Studio 2017 command prompt here, dir, then hello world, cd, hello world, okay. Dir means gives us hello cpp, this is the file. This is the file hello cpp. We are at this folder. Now we are compiling this program, hello cpp. CL is C++ compiler and linker. Then we give hello cpp like this. If we press enter, then it creates hello exe, dir. It creates hello exe, hello exe. Then it runs as expected. Okay, say we can give, if we want to use it, this compiles this command. So here I will put here some message, cl hello cpp compiles and generates hello obj. This file is called object file and links hello exe. This is called executable file. Okay, so this command, this CL, C++ compiler and link command, this command compiles. It first compiles. Compile means generate object file. Then links. Link means generate object executable files. Executable file. So compile means generate object file and link means generate exe file, executable file. Okay, so we will learn what command line switch means. Command line switch. The very first command line switch we are going to learn is this command. Okay, this command is compile only. Compile only means do not generate exe file. Okay, so let's try it here. DL now I will delete obj file too. Now here we only have hello cpp, cl, c, hello cpp. Okay, this command dir gives, this command generates obj file, but there is no exe. There is no exe file. Okay, compiles only. Do not generate exe file. This is compile switch. This is called compilation. Compilation means the process that generates obj file. Okay, obj file is called object file. Object obj. Obj files are called object files. So compilation process means generate object file. Okay, then we can link. Then this point we have obj files like this here, hello obj. Now we can link. We can use the cl command again, hello obj. It now generates hello exe. Now it generates hello exe. Hello exe. Okay, then the link, we use cl command again, hello obj. This command links hello obj and generates exe or executable file. Okay, so this means links. Link means generate executable files. Then you may wonder why we compile and link separately. Why? Say with this command cl hello cpp, it means compile and link and generate executables. Okay, then why we say cl c hello ob cpp, just compile only and generate obj File, then CL, Hello, OBJ, Link to generate exe file. While we are using just one step, this is just one step to create executable files, then it uses two steps. Just this is for compilation only, compile only, then we link OBJ file to generate exe file while we are using these two steps. Actually, there are lots of reasons why we have to compile only and sometimes we link only. In Visual Studio, in fact, when we build, when we actually create this solution, when we hit here F5, here F5, it actually compiles twice. It actually first it compiles this CPP file, stdafx, this it compiles files separately, then it links the files. See, it uses two files in this case, stdaf, it has two CPP files here, 1, 2, and also two header files here. In case of Visual Studio 2015 here, it also has two CPP files, okay, this one and this one. Also header files, one header file in this case. So it in this case, the reason, okay, I will type in here. The primary reason to separately compile and link is for optimization, no, not optimization, for efficiency of compile of build. Okay, so if we can generate OBJ files separately, we can sometimes save lots of time. We can save time. You may say, wow, just one click, this one hit, this is just one hit, we generate OBJ file and executable a single click. But it takes more, it takes more time taking compiling first, then linking again. Actually, this second way is more efficient. The reason is that if the source file is not changed, say this is just one file only, but in this case there are two source files, and when you build C++, you will have lots of source files, separate source files. Okay, in such case, for example, stdafx, this file would never change, almost never change in the course of development. If we compile this file again and again, compile means generating OBJ file, object file again and again, it wastes a lot of time. But if we link only once, we compile only once and link again, then we can save a lot of time. Okay, I will give concrete example. We will add here one more file, util.cpp. Okay, I created a util file. Here, I create a function, int sum, int a, int b, return a plus b. Okay, I created a function here in separate file. This is function header. I will copy function header here. Okay, then here we can access this file, std cout 1 plus 2 equals sum 2, std and there. Please note that this sum function is defined in util in this file. Okay, we save all. Then to compile the to build this application, we have to do like this. CL, hello, CPP, util, CPP. Okay. So we compiled and linked, then generated. This means compile and link and generate hello exe. Okay. But instead of doing this, we can do like this. CL, see, we compile only once. CT, say main CPP, main CPP. Okay. No, hello CPP, hello CPP. Okay. Then we say we only change, we build, we compiled, we generate OBJ file here, dir OBJ. We generate hello OBJ, but we don't change anything. We only change here. For example, instead of A, we would say, we would change like this. Now we changed our code. Then we here, we don't need to. Now we can do like this. Hello OBJ, because OBJ, this hello CPP is never changed from after since our last compilation. We just provide util CPP. Only this file is changed. Then it saves a lot of time. Okay. It compiles much faster because we only compile the util, this file alone. But if we instead compile both CPP, util, CPP, it compiles two files, hello CPP, util. But if we do this, we compile only util file. So this way is much faster. This way is faster. This way is slow. In this case, this way is slow because we have to compile both. The primary reason to separately compile and link is for efficiency of the build process. So build means compile and link and generate executables. And compile means generate object file or .obj. Okay, so link means generate executable or exe or dll files. Okay, so I hope you understand that build, compile, link, all these are different meanings. And now I will address about the concept of preprocessor. Okay, so let's go back to here. Now I will introduce a header file. So we currently have two files, hello util, and I will create a header file, say util.h. Okay, I create the file. Here, instead of this function declaration here, I will put the header file here, function header. This is called function header, control K S to save all. Then here we include util.h. Okay, because the reason we have to include this header file, util, this header file, is that we are going to use consume this sum function here. The C++ compiler should know the what sum means in this case. So here we are in command line again. Here, So we can come now. Now here we can compile and link the same way as before, like this. So if we don't include this header file, save, then C++ compiler will complain. Okay, C++ compiler will complain. So the sum identifier not found. So we have to provide compiler, C++ compiler, this header file. This header file declares what some function means here in this file. So we are currently using, we are in this project, we have three files. This is a header file. H is a header file. This is code source file. This is declaration. This is called declaration. And this is called definition. This is called function. Definition. This is called function declaration. Function declaration. Okay. Now to save all, Ctrl K S. So now we will learn what pre-processing means. Okay. Now here, CL. C means compile only. P means generate preprocessor. Hello. CPP. It will generate preprocessor file here. You can find hello I. Okay, hello I. I will open this file here. Hello I. If I open it, I open the hello I file here. So it starts, the code looks very different here. I will explain. Hello file here, pragma once. It goes like this. What are these code? Okay, what are these code? When in hello here, hello CPP, it starts with the IO stream. Okay, we include IO stream. The contents of the file IO stream, right click, then go to definition. Then hello IO stream, this is a file. Okay, this is hello IO stream is actually a file. Then the contents of this file will be replaced here. And it is generated like this. Wow, it looks a lot of code. We can scroll down to the end here. If at the end of, then we say line hello CPP here, int sum. Because here we included UTIL. Instead of UTIL, the contents of this file, this contents is copied here, copied verbatim here. Okay, stripping of comments. Then this file is called preprocessor. Okay, this file, preprocessed file. This preprocessed file is called translation unit. So preprocessing means here preprocessing means include, replace header files, header, replace, include directives, header file, contents in the source code, in the CPP file. Okay, before compilation means two process. Compilation is two step processes. First it process pre-process then generate obj object files. So pre-process include files, then generate obj files. Compilation means to process, pre-processing and generate obj files. So this, how to generate preprocessor? This is command line switch, compile only. P means pre-process the files. Okay, so if we type, then this extension, I extension of this file is created. This is the step of processing. Also, to understand more of the pre-processing, I will close this file. Now I define here, I will define a macro. Here I define int max. I defined a macro. This is called a preprocessor macro. I defined a preprocessor macro. I save it. Ctrl KS. Then here, I can use std cout int max is int max std and there. Okay, this is macro, preprocessor macro here. Now I save it, Ctrl KS. Now here, let's see. Now let's preprocess once again. So it is redefined. It says why it is redefined. I will change something else. Int max 10. I will change like that. This int max is defined somewhere, so I will change it. Int max 10 here. Int max 10. Now saved here. Let's try once again. Why int max? I have to change the int max. Now let's see. Now I will add here underscore because it complains it is defined somewhere else. Okay. Now Ctrl KS. Now here, let's build once again. Okay, no error. Now let's open it. So after pre-processing, if we scroll down here, now let's compare this one. Let's pay attention to this line of code. Okay, this is our source code. And here, this int max 10 is replaced with 10 after pre-processing. After pre-processing, this macro pre-processor macro is replaced. Okay, so during pre-processing stage, the compiler replaces or substitutes pre-processor macros. Okay, so this is pre-processing stage, but there is another way to define pre-processor here. Now I close this file. Now I say std cout I say command line defined, defined. I would define cmd int 10. I will define like this, std, and please note that we haven't defined this macro. We haven't defined this macro. Control KS. Now here, we can define this macro. Here, say D. We define D. CMD. INT. 10. Like 20. Okay. Please note that the syntax. Then here I define T means we define macro. Then if we open it, if we open this file again, please note that it is replaced with 20. Because I defined it 20, okay? This is the source code. I will close this document. Please compare with these two files. CMD INT 10. Okay, I save it once again. This is replaced, updated like this. Now comes here again. Now here I provide 30. Then compile again. It is reloaded. It is replaced with 30, okay? Because I changed it 30. Here, if I try it with 50, 40, then it will be changed to 40. Okay, let's see side by side. Pay attention to here, this part. 50, okay? I will give 50, it will change to 50. Enter. Okay, this file is updated to 50. So this way we can define macro here. This is, we defined command line macro. We defined macro in command line. Okay, we defined macro in command line. This is we defined in source code. Here, we defined int max 10 in source code. This we defined in command line. Say, sometimes defining macro on command line is very important. Sometimes it plays some very important role defining command line macros like this. So this session we learned how to compile. We now understand the concept of compile and link, and also we understand command line macro or preprocessor. And this file, after processing all preprocessors, this is preprocessed file. This file is called translation unit. So translation unit means here translation unit means CPP files that is preprocessed is called translation unit. I hope you understand the very fundamentals. In next session, we will learn what we mean by precompiled header. We will learn in next session about the precompiled header. Thank you for watching.